everyone. Okay, so we've had our wraps on for a while, so today we're going to go over the different removal procedures. I'm going to go over about four of them today, and I'm going to be using my Jamberry nail wrap fingers to show you and demonstrate how each of these procedures are done. The first procedure, we are going to be needing a dental floss pick, an oil of your choice. It could be olive oil, canola oil, vegetable oil, coconut oil. In this case, we're going to be using olive oil. Grab a shot glass or any glass container that you can pour the oil into. Make sure you grab an orange stick or just anything pointy that can kind of lift stuff up, lift up the edges. So if you've had your Jamberry nail wraps on for a while, it'll naturally start lifting up where there's growth in your nail. So it'll start lifting up a little bit. So the first way that we're gonna use is the dental floss tip. You're gonna get your finger, you're gonna dip it in the oil. Just kind of soak it in oil just a little bit. And then once it's in the oil, what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our orange stick, and with the flat edge, we're going to lift up the edges just a tad. So lift up the edges, go around, and it should come up fairly easily. So once you have lifted up the edges a tad, and do you see how it just easily comes up? What we're gonna do is we're gonna dip it back in the oil, get our dental floss pick, you're gonna slide it right under, then just be gentle and wiggle it. Voila. Nail wrap is off. That's the first method. Very, very simple. The second method that we're gonna be using is going to be with a cotton ball. So if you don't have a jar, but you just want a cotton ball, what you can do is just grab a cotton ball, dip the cotton ball in some of the oil, get some oil on this finger. Once you have the oil on the cotton ball, what you're gonna do is you're just gonna put it directly on the nail wrap, as so. When it's a little bit loose, what you're gonna do is you're going to grab your orange stick, and you wanna make sure you tuck it underneath the nail wrap, so it gets a little bit of lift. Grab your cotton ball, and you're just gonna kind of soak the oil-soaked cotton ball, and just soak your fingernail. Just get it really, really oily. Grab your orange stick, and then just continue to work your way around. And it should come off fairly easily, just as so. And there will be residue, so be sure to use your cotton ball and remove the excess residue, just as so. All right, the third way is a very simple way, and this is a way that you can use if you're on the run and you don't have much time, you don't have olive oil with you, and you just want to take it off. This definitely isn't as gentle as the first two methods with the oil that I showed you, but what I recommend is getting some alcohol wipes, just any alcohol wipes. Open it up. And then what you're going to do with the alcohol wipe, just put it on your nail. Put it on your nail, just kind of get it wet. And because, you know, you're traveling, you probably aren't going to have an orange stick with you. Get your finger, and what you can do is you can just kind of go around your nail. Go around your nail gently, and just kind of, it should easily come up. So when it comes up just a little bit, continue to get your alcohol swab and work your way around. Just work your way around, and then just with your fingernail, just kind of start peeling it off, and it should come right off. That is the third method. And we can remove the residue. The fourth and final method is the heat, using heat to remove your Jamberry nail. So what we're going to do is we are going to grab our orange stick. Again, we're going to kind of lift it up gently at the edges. Just work around, get a little bit of lift. Then what we're going to do is we're going to get our heat source. In this instance, I'm going to be using our Jamberry nail heater. I'm going to turn on the heater so it gets hot. Once it gets hot, what we're going to do is we're going to grab our finger with the nail wrap on. We're going to put it in front of the heat for a little bit. Take it away for a couple seconds, put it back for a couple seconds. Grab our orange stick and then just gently lift. It will be very, very hot. It'll be moldable and it should come right off, just as so. There's residue, so again, feel free to grab a paper towel, grab your alcohol swab, grab a napkin, anything to remove the residue. All right, and now the fifth bonus method is gonna be with nail polish remover. Now, a lot of people have the colored nail polish remover that they will use, but the thing is, if just to give you a heads up, treat this as you would oil. Don't think that just because you're using nail polish remover that you're not gonna have to wash your hands with this grease cutting soap afterwards. Because if you have nail polish remover and if it has color in it, then chances are it has gelatin or it has moisturizing agents in it. So it actually will prevent your nail wrap, your new nail wrap, from sticking to your nail really, really well. So you can use this. This is another removal method. You can use it just like you did with the oil. You can use the nail polish remover, get it on the cotton ball. You can soak the cotton ball, put it on your nail, grab your orange stick, and lift it up just a little bit as so. Go around, lift. Grab the nail polish remover. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna just get your orange stick, lift gently. As you're lifting gently, continue to get your nail polish remover soaked in the cotton ball. Make your way under. And it will come right off. It's off. So make sure if you use the oil or if you use the nail polish remover with the color in it, or even if you use, even if you use the alcohol swab, because some oil from your fingers may get on it, make sure you wash your hands with this dishwashing soap afterwards thoroughly. Don't put lotion on, and then you can buff your nails and then put on your new wraps. So I hope that this helped. I'll be back next week with a new video. I hope everybody has a great week and a happy Easter, and I'll see you next Monday. Bye.